Hello everyone and welcome to my poster presentation where we want to explore enhancer promoter interactions based on their predicted transcription factor binding sites using topic modeling. First of all, a short overview. We want to have a look at regulatory regions in the DNA which affect the gene expression of their target genes. So they can be located pretty far away from the target genes and they are bound by transcription factors which then recruit other cofactors. And also form complexes with the transcription factors that are bound in the promoter side of a gene. And we are interested in exactly these transcription factors, so which are bound in the enhancer, which in the promoter, is there maybe a specific pattern to it? First of all, we need some interactions to analyze, and we do so by using the ABC score, the activity by contact score, proposed by Volker and others. And the idea is that enhancers that are relevant for a gene have a high activity and also a high contact frequency with the gene. So you look at all the candidate enhancers in a window, calculate the score, activity, multiplied with the contact, and then look at their relative contribution to the score for each gene indicated here. So by this you can identify the enhancers that have, compared to all the other candidate enhancers in a region, a pretty high score, so they might be the ones that are relevant. And we do this for all possible enhancer gene connections, and then take the one which have a high score and say, okay, these are not the ones that are interesting. To use topic modeling, we first need to construct a count matrix for the transcription factors. We first cluster similar motifs with MOSTER, then use FIMU to predict the transcription factor binding size. We normalize the counts for length and also subtract the counts on shuffled sequences. So if you have an interaction, you would say these transcription factors are bound on the enhancer and the promoter, and this interaction would be one row in the matrix. So first you have all the transcription factors bound in the enhancer region, and then the same transcription factors, but now the counts for the promoter region. And this count matrix can be used in topic modeling, and we use latent Dirichlet allocation, and this then construct unobserved groups, the so-called topics, which try to explain similarities in the data, so similarities in the transcription factor binding sites in the interactions. And it returns two probability distributions. First of all, the importance of a TF for a topic. So on the right you can see that for each of the 20 topics we used in this approach, you see which of the transcription factors are the most important ones. And you see that some seem to be pretty relevant for defining a topic. And with a small, if the transcription factor has a small e in front, it means that it was counted in the enhancer side of the interaction, and a p stands for the promoter. And one way to look at this data or to get more insight into it would be to take the relevant transcription factors in a topic, put them into a string database and see what interactions do we find, just this makes sense. Topic modeling also returns the probability of an interaction to belong to a topic. So for each interaction, it says which topic does describe this interaction the best. And this can help, as shown on the right, to cluster interactions together, which are assigned to similar topics. And with this, you can further characterize these interactions by integrating other genomics data. Maybe are there other features that are similar among these interactions? So thank you for listening. If you have any questions, feel free to contact me via mail or via the conference platform, and I wish you a nice day.